Pixel by Fanie Viljoen. Published by LAPA Publishers and narrated by Chris Daffy. Produced by Mic Drop Media. To Mimi Duplessis, who gave wings to my words. You taught me so much about stories. Thanks for believing in my weird ideas. Chapter 1. The Incredible Loneliness of Felix Foxly. In a part of the city where people lived behind towering walls stood a big, big house in a big, big yard. And in the big, big house lived a boy with a small, small voice and an even smaller heart. "When are you coming home, Mum?" asked Felix Foxly, his voice barely above a whisper. Anxiously, he stared at his mom's image on the cell phone screen. He pushed his hand through his red hair. Then he pushed his glasses back on his nose. "We're running a bit late, Felix," said his mom. She ruffled through some papers on her desk. "Daddy and I still have to finish up some work."
"But I'm all alone," said Felix.
"Mommy knows you've been alone many times before. Order some food online. We'll see you later. Bye-bye now, darling." Felix tried to keep her on the line, but his mom's image disappeared off the screen. For quite a while after the call had ended, Felix remained seated in the chair near the front door, his legs pulled up to his chest. His eyes moved across their home, the huge entrance hall, the broad staircase, the majestic living room to the left, the expansive study to the right, and further down the hallway, the colossal kitchen. Everything was quiet in the massive house, dead quiet. Felix sighed. Dragging his feet, he made his way to the entertainment room. For a short time, he played some TV games. Later, he ordered a pizza. His mom and dad worked late every day of their lives. That is why their bank information was stored on Felix's cell phone. Like so many times before, he used it again to pay for the pizza. Eventually, he hopped off the couch and quickly ran upstairs to fetch his airplane from his room. It was his latest toy. Amazingly, you could control it by using an app on your cell phone. Felix loved the red plane. He had even taken it apart before, trying to find out how exactly it worked, how all the little bits fit together, what made it take off and land. He took things apart regularly. Then he would try to reassemble them. It was kind of his hobby. Whenever he ran into trouble fixing things again, he searched the internet for help. With the airplane tucked under his arm, Felix opened the great front door of their house. He made his way down the 21 steps to the garden. Above him, the clouds rumbled. It would probably rain soon, but not right now. Finding a smooth runway, Felix switched on the airplane. Using his cell phone, he slowly guided it down the path, letting it take off eventually. The buttons on the phone controlled every movement. He steered the plane into a left turn around a tree, then a right turn around the garden bench, crossing the fish pond, then the swimming pool, and back again. As he was about to make another flyover, Felix suddenly heard a man calling from the front gate. "Pizza! Did you order a pizza?" The unexpected voice distracted Felix for a mere second. Before he knew it, his plane had sped off course, zooming right into a tree and spluttering to a standstill. There it remained, miserably dangling from one of the branches. "Hey, boy!" cried the pizza guy again. "Hurry up! The pizza's getting cold! I've got to get to the other deliveries! I don't have all day!" Felix rushed to the enormous gate with its curly bars of iron. The pizza guy pushed the box into his hands. Hurriedly, he leapt back onto his delivery bike. Felix had hoped he could have had a little chat. Or at the least, they would have liked to say thank you, but the pizza guy took off in a flash, disappearing right down the street. Felix was left standing at the gate, alone, with a cold pizza in a box. He gazed up and down the street to see if there was anyone else around, but all he could see were towering walls and giant gates. It felt like he was completely alone in the world, and before he knew it, the rain came pouring down on him. Chapter 2. Miss Tiddlespout. Every morning in the Foxly's home was exactly the same as the last. A disorderly jumble, a frenzied befuddlement. Today was no exception. It was as if the ticking of the old grandfather clock kept pace, for all the chaos.
Felix's dad rushed around grabbing building plans for his latest office construction. His mom crammed together all her work stuff, talked on her cell phone and tried putting on her shoes, all at once. A lonely ray of sunlight fell through the windows of the old house. Felix sat at the table in the dimly lit kitchen, watching his parents. "Dad, may I please ask you something?" he said as his dad stormed past again. Oh, his dad sighed. "Could you or Mom please find me somebody to play with?"
"You mean like a dog?" asked his dad. "You know I'm super allergic to animals, my boy."
"And cats tinkle all over the place," said his mom. She had finally managed to slip her shoes on. Now she was trying to fix her hair that was scrunched atop her head like a rat's nest.
"But I'm all alone every day," said Felix.
"No, you're not," replied his dad, absent-mindedly. "You've got all those books in your room, a whole bookcase full. Books are one's best friend."
"You can't talk to books," said Felix.
Again his dad let out a heavy sigh. Sighing was one of the things his dad did most of all, especially when he didn't have time to explain stuff.
"Talk to Miss Tittlespout, your homeschool teacher. She'll be here in a minute. We have to be on our way now. Have you seen the car keys?"
Felix's mom stared in horror at the grandfather clock in the dining room. It was still ticking away the time briskly. "Oh dear, the day hasn't even begun yet, and I'm already a day behind in my work." Side by side, Felix's mom and dad rushed out the front door, cell phones glued to their ears. The door banged shut behind them. The sound echoed through the empty house. Felix's face dropped. They had forgotten to say goodbye to him. He would only see them again in the evening. They would surely be working late, as always. It was going to be one of those horrible days at home again. The thought had barely crossed his mind when the doorbell rang. No, it wasn't his mum and dad who had returned to say goodbye. That much Felix knew. Making his way to the entrance hall, he opened the front door. As it swung open, Miss Tittlespout turned sharply on her heels towards him. She was as pale as spoiled milk. Her eyes stared down on him like those of the grumpy people you find in dusty paintings in old museums. To crown it all, she had the temper of an impending thunderstorm. Miss Tittlespout was once a schoolteacher, but hordes of children apparently made her sick. Felix was therefore her only student. His parents preferred it that way. They wanted only the very best for their boy. Schools were nothing but raucous institutions where no proper learning could ever take place. Or so they believed. Miss Tittlespout cleared her throat impatiently.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.